Welcome to NetSet OS. This is our seventh video in regex tutorial. In this video, we will begin by learning two meta characters, open and closed square braces. It is mainly used to define a custom character set. If you remember in the last video, we discussed about t.ch, which we have defined in regular expression, and we were trying to detect the words besides teach. So we got to know this character where it has the space, comma. In this, it is detecting all kind of characters, whether it is comma, space, colon, semicolon, as dot character allows us. Now let's delete this. And here I'll define beer as well as beer. Now if I write regular expression for it, it will be B-E-R. Now if I have to match with both of these strings, I'll make a dot over here so that it can match both these strings. Now with this, if I write here B-E-S-R, B-E semicolon R, B-E dot R, B-E space R. Now in this, I'm making a condition over here that it should not detect the punctuations between B-E and R. I just want a vowel over here. Here, I can make usage of character set, as I'll make use of square brackets. And here, I'll define all the vowels. A-E-I-O-U. So you can see, it's just detecting the vowels and we are only having two strings. So basically it makes a tight range so that these kind of character cannot come in this. Characters, I mean to say, this punctuations. I don't want commas, space, colon, semicolon, nothing. I just want vowels over here. And regular expression is all about conditions. Now let's take the other strings as sensor as well as sensor, and I want regular expression to be matching with both of them. So here I can write C-A-N-S dot R. Now here also there can be condition C-N-S space R, or rather C-E-N-S comma R. I don't want that. So here I can define A-E-I-O-U for vowels. Now what if I get such condition C-E-N-S-O-U-R? Here these two are vowels. So why it is not detecting? The answer is, it is only a single character. So we have C-E-N-S and then square brackets O-U followed by R, it would not match the word sensor because it is always giving a single character. Even though it looks same visually, but with this we can have just a single character. So we need to be careful with this. Now let's delete this and I'll be writing some of the strings like NetSet OS, some of the languages, Python, Java, data science, Perl, and more. So this is going to be text where we are going to search for our regular expression. I'll start with searching for vowel over here. So I'll write square bracket A-E-I-O-U, right? Now you can see, it is just giving me E because it is in standard mode. Now I'll go to flag and will click on global. With clicking of global, it is detecting all the vowels for our string. But if you see it carefully, it is not detecting for Java. A is not detected for A-E-I-O-U as it is in smaller case. And A I have defined over here with uppercase. So here I can write A-E-I-O-U. So with this, it is detecting all the upper case vowels as well as lower case vowels. Now, if I swap it, instead of A, E, I, O, I can write O, E, I. It will detect the same. There will be no effect on this. Let's try out with numerical values. For that, I'll delete all these strings. And here I'll write the roll numbers. Let's say Anita has roll number 1. Monica, roll number 2. Devi, roll number 5. Ram, roll number 9. Now I got a situation where I just need to detect the numbers. Mostly in projects we used to get these kind of conditions where we need not to detect the characters. Just we want the numerical value. My client asked me to just detect the numerical value. So what I'll do, I'll write the regex as hyphen. With this, I'll put square brackets. And here, I'll write all the numbers from 0 to 9. So this is how it is detecting all the numerical values. And here, we are not getting even a single string value. So with this, I also got a name with, let's say, Sham with number, let's say, 56. So here you can see it is just detecting 5. As I have already told you, the square brackets is always detecting a single digit, not more than that. So here it is only detecting 5. Let's try out with punctuations, where I have thank you with exclamation mark, thank you with full stop, thank you, let's say semicolon. So we could come up here and make our regular expression as with square brackets, exclamation mark, full stop, semicolon, and I'll close this square bracket. So you can see it is detecting all the punctuation marks. Now let's take it more further. Till here we have discussed about character sets, where character set is just a way of defining a custom set of values that can be in any single character position. Mind it, it is single character position. And we are customizing it as per our usage. Now let's come up with character range. Character range is a very important topic which helps us a lot with character sets. Character range is denoted by hyphen, which indicates range of characters. For example, if we had a character set that was to match any number, then we usually define it by 0 to 9. And if we wanted to match any lowercase letter, then we could create a character set and put all the lowercase letters from A to Z, as like this. And for the uppercase, it's same A to A, B, C, D, E, F, G till Y, Z. But if we wanted to have a character set that would match any uppercase letter as well as any lowercase letter with any number, then we will have to write a lot of information. First 0 to 9, then A to Z in lowercase, then in uppercase. And that too, it will be targeting a single character only. Their character range takes our pain. We use the meta character, which is just a dash, or we can say hyphen, to indicate a range of characters. This hyphen includes all characters between two characters. Let's say, if we have to define from 0 to 9, we can write it as 0 to 9. That is 0 hyphen 9. And if we have to define from A to Z in lowercase, A to Z. And for uppercase, capital A to capital Z. Let's say in our last example where we have used Anita 1. And here I want to detect all the uppercase. So what I'll do, with brackets, capital A hyphen capital Z. I'll get all the capital letters, whether it is A, M, D, R, S. Now I want to detect all the lowercase. So what I'll do? I'll go for small a to small z. Now it can detect all the lowercase letters. Now if I want to detect all the numerical values, I can go for 0 to 9. Now let's detect all the uppercase as well as lowercase. So I can go for capital A to Z as well as small a to Z. So with this, we got all the alphabetical orders, whether it is uppercase or lowercase. But for numerical values, if I write 0 to 9, it is detecting all the numbers. Now if I write over here 56 to 99. But what is this? Here we are just getting 5 and 9. Because here regular expression plays a trick. Because if we are given 56 to 99, I'll write over here. It doesn't mean from 56 value to 99. It means 6 to 9. It's just a range of one character from 6 to 9. With this, we will have 5 and 9. That's why it is detecting 5 and 9. 4 is exceeding this limit. Between 6 to 9, we won't be able to have 4, 1 or 2. Now if I give number as 8, let's take a name Nina with 8. It is detecting it. Here it is detecting it because 8 lies between 6 to 9. So be careful, it's not a number range. It's just a range between where hyphen is lying between the numbers from 6 to 9. Now let's take another example where I have a number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3, 4, 5 separated by hyphen. And I'll delete this regular expression. And with this, I'll just write 0 to 9. So with this, it will be detecting all the numerical values as it is matching all of those numbers. Now here, if I want to match some numbers with a real pattern, so we could repeat this. I'll copy this and paste over here. Then again. So you can see we have covered 0 to 9 4 times as per 0, 1, 2, 3. Hyphen is used. So I'll use over here hyphen. Then again, there is 4. So I can repeat this range again. Then again, it is covering up 5. Then again, it is covering up 6 also. Then I'll put hyphen. Then I'll give the range 3 times. Now it matches the whole number. Notice here that the dash inside this character range and also a dash outside the range. This dash outside the square bracket is literal character. I have made a video on literal characters. You can check it out in my rejects tutorial. But you can use the same technique to match zip codes, ID numbers, security numbers. In the exact same way. So character range are a useful tool when working with character sets. Now in the next video, I'll be coming up with negative character sets. Here I'm covering up all the small topics related to regex. After that, I'll be coming up with conceptual videos on regex. So be with me and please like, comment and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.